raised earlier, but just to complete the thought here, the president will attack Michael Cohen's credibility, no question. Cohen's answer to that is that, listen, yes, I lied before, but now I want to make it right. This is the duty of my family, to country. In effect, he wants to be the John Dean, who famously a Nixon White House lawyer who then turned state's evidence and then served prison time. He wants to be the John Dean of the story. Is that right?
Yeah, and you know whether he succeeds in that remains to be seen, but the proof is in the pudding when Mueller can use his information. And if he continues to cooperate and Mueller finds his information valuable, that's going to be what's telling. Now, remember, Cohen is the guy who knows where the bodies are buried. Okay, metaphorically speaking, of course. And beyond this, just think about what he might be able to verify or not verify. You know, Cohen is mentioned in the Steele dossier as someone who traveled to Prague to pay off Russian hackers. Now, maybe that's true, maybe it's not, but he could, you know, dispute, he could start to, you know, cross out things that are true and not true, that are still in speculation.
Right. And remember, that Prague trip is something that Michael Cohen has denied publicly in the most vehement terms. I've never been to Prague. It's all made up. Is that operative, that statement, still? I mean, that's obviously a question that we'd want to answer. But remember, this just shows that it's all connected, because the WikiLeaks effort, which is what Prague relates to, was another attempt by Russia to ingratiate itself with the Trump campaign. Here, you have financial interests of the president or the candidate Trump and his family in Russia. And the question that hovers over all of this that is just so important, which is, was Donald Trump doing the nation's business with Russia, or is he doing his family's personal financial business?
And even if a deal doesn't come to fruition, it is still important that discussions about a potential deal that can be financially beneficial to the then presumptive nominee is being talked about.
Exactly, because it deals with the question of motive. Cross.
New York Times, I believe, in that interview, he said, yeah, this is the red line.
This is directly related to the question of Russian election interference. And here's why. Not just because the lack of transparency did not provide people with, you know, full information on why he was taking certain steps, but that at every step, by keeping it secret, Russia has had leverage over him, has had essentially compromise. And every lie that's told to keep it secret has been even more leverage.
Good point.
This is a national security issue, and that is what Mueller is investigating.
Yes, secret personal information is part of compromise, right?
Exactly.
By definition.
Well, and Putin continues, by the way, to have leverage now going into future meetings, because you have to, I mean, meetings with Moscow, there are two parties to that. There's a Moscow side and a U.S. side. What does Putin have? What people are in the Soviet Union who can actually ratify Cohen's claims here? So
correct.
Putin has a lot of leverage to use against the president in future negotiations.
So who oversees the Mueller probe now? The new acting attorney general, Matthew Whitaker, has criticized the probe. Secondly, what did the president retweet last night? A meme with Rod Rosenstein, who had previously overseen the probe, behind bars, saying he should never have hired the special counsel.
It also happens the week the Senate Republicans blocked even a vote. It was a bipartisan proposal on the Senate floor to pass legislation to protect Robert Mueller. Didn't even get a vote on the Senate floor. That timing will be interesting, in part, as we watch the president's response.
And, you know, I think that this is, it's going to be interesting to see how Trump responds to the fact that Whitaker hasn't been able to stop any of this, if that's what he expected. The wheels of justice have continued to.
There you go.
Mueller is a tough adversary, right? Listen, thanks to all of you. Thank you. Much to digest these past hours.
Yeah. The breaking news continues. Thank you for being with us for it. I'm Poppy Harlow.
And I'm Jim Sciutto. At this hour with our colleague Kate Baldwin continues our breaking news coverage right now.